your favorite live show that you've seen and why?
Ooh, that's a hard one. I've had a few good experiences with Alejandro, being a fan and just him coming out and being able to talk to him. So it's hard to say, because in Nashville, I was lucky to run into him after the show, and Nashville was a phenomenal concert. But you got to think, what show? Is it show with the band or show without the band? Because without the band, it's hard, because I have Nashville, that was an amazing concert. I was lucky, my daughter got to, give him a stuffed animal. Actually, I threw it onto him on stage, and he took it. He actually waved for me to take it, which was really cool. And we actually ran into him probably 30 minutes later on the bridge. And he, my daughter got to hug him. It was really cool. He was really cool about it. Got to take a picture. He was really down to earth. I shook his hand, and, I felt so much love for this man, when I shook his hand, and how genuine he was. He's just a genuine person. There's other people that are genuine, nice, sincere, but you can feel it when you actually meet him. You know that he's caring, and he cares about things. So, he was so nice to my daughter. That was one of the things that really, touched my heart as well. So Nashville was special. Pomona was special too, the first day, because when I went to the concert, he actually stopped, after a song and started talking to me about the tattoo. I really got the tattoo. So that was a cool moment too. Gosh, it's hard to just pick that one or that one. And then I'll tell you, Fort Lauderdale, when I went to that with the band, that was different. So it's hard to pick the solo one between, but I would say Pomona. I mean, even though it was hot there in Pomona, I don't know, Nashville, it's hard to say Nashville and Pomona, because they're both wonderful concerts, They had their own, fabulous ways about them, magical ways, mm-hmm. But to me, Fort Lauderdale with the band was special, because I was able to, see Max, took a picture with Travis. And it was a good moment. And then Alejandro, there was like four of us in line. I had Lynn there. There was a few other fans. And Alejandro comes walking, out the door. That I don't know why he was walking out the far door, because his van's in the back, and that's where they go in and out and do stuff. But it's like there's only four fans, but he came out to walk. He was walking with Oscar and another friend, and we got to chat with him for a little bit. That was cool. Lynn was there. Lynn kind of clammed up a little bit, but she was cute, she was cute and said hi. But I got to chat with him a little bit and thank him, and said, Orlando was awesome. He thanked me and thanked the girl that was next to me, because we both went, Lynn went to Orlando too as well. And, we got a good experience there to talk to him again. So I was thankful for that. So there's a few times that I was thankful to have experience with Alejandro as a fan. Because I'm not a friend of Alejandro's, but, I would love to work with him one day. I'd love to go on the road. I'd love to do, any kind of repair, electrical, security, or anything like that. I would love to work with him. Well, the Nashville show was special. It was special because it was outside. It was his first show away from AI, American Idol. And it was just special. There was a few songs that he didn't do there, in other places, except like one time I think he did the Fly Away. I forgot what that song is named. It's not really, there's no name to that song, so we just speculate. But yeah, it's hard to pick that. That was a better atmosphere because you weren't sweating and you didn't have the crampedness in Nashville. So I have to say Nashville was the best.
Nashville had like 45 minutes of streamed music. He played the keyboards and pulled out the guitar, if I remember right. For like 45 minutes. It was crazy. He hasn't really done that big of a block of just streaming music live yet since.
I think it's longer than 45 minutes. Remember, he had the 10 minutes of ambient in the beginning.
Yeah, I was including that in. I don't remember at this point, but it was just amazingly long. It was unique to anything he's done since. Any of these little pop-up shows he does in L.A., either of his tours, it was very unique.
I thought it was over an hour. I mean, it felt like that. It really did feel like that because it flowed. It was so good. It was just so good to be there and be. I was right in the second row. I was the first one there in the morning, but I was second row because I had snacks for the kids. They weren't letting snacks in. So I had to say, you can have my bag. And I walked away. I walked with the kids, said, let's go sit down. They can have my bag. So we got the second row, but I got right in the middle. So it was awesome. It was still awesome to do it because I had to live stream for the fans. So that was one of the things I wanted to, I want to make sure I had a good position to, because I've never live streamed before that date, you know, to make sure the fans got a view of this concert.
Boy, those live streams early on, those first few shows, Nashville show and the beginning of the summer tour, those were so important. I mean, so many people saw those live streams and were able to join in.
They were very special. I remember I used to always feel like in the beginning we used to do the live streams and we would have 60, 80 people in there just listening to the music. It was amazing. I don't know, I felt like that's a special time in the past because we don't really do that anymore. And, you know, there is this emphasis on not always live streaming and putting down the phone, and I think that that's important. But I do cherish those moments that we got to watch the streams, right? Because we couldn't go, and it was such a feeling of togetherness at that point. Loved it.
Yeah. So. Yeah, it was amazing, the live stream. I mean, I wanted to do this for the fans. I looked at my phone, there was like over 500 people watching. I said, no way. There's only 500 people watching this live stream? I was like shocked. It was around 500. It started out like 100 something, and it started creeping up. And I was shocked at it, you know? And I didn't do the whole live stream the whole way through. Because Alejandro was talking about having their phones and being in the moment. And then he was looking at me. This is my first interaction ever with Alejandro. He's looking at me. So I'm like looking at him feeling bad. Because I'm still live streaming. And it's like he said something like, you know. And then he started singing again. So I'm like looking at him. So I like point at my phone. I do a cutthroat with my hand. And he's sitting there singing Millennial Love. And he shakes his head looking at me to cut my phone off. So I said, okay. I have to give him the respect because, you know, even though I'm live streaming for the fans, I need to cut this off and I need to, you know, have respect that he wanted me to not live stream the show. But I didn't even go back on after the show. I actually cut it there. But other people had the rest of the video. So I know a lot of people were sad that the live stream didn't go all the way through. And that's the only live stream I've ever done. And I think that's probably a last one. But, you know, just because I know how he feels about live streams and stuff.
Yeah, no, don't worry about that, Tom. The best of us have had Alejandro like look up and lock eyes with us in the middle of Millennial Love, and it really is the most intense experience right in the middle of Millennial Love because of the message of that song. Yeah. That happened to me at Abbott Kinney, if I'm saying that right. That's the Venice
show we did down there. I watched it live from years. I did.
Yeah, I had the live stream, and he looked up, and he looked right at me, and I was literally, you know, it was a small stage off on a side street, and it was probably the smallest crowd I've seen for anything he's done post-Idol, and he looked right up, right at that particular time, and, you know, he threw out an F-bomb in that song like he used to like to do to get his point across, and he got his point across, man, and it was just moments after that I took that photo with him that photo that I posted a few times, and it's kind of an awkward photo. I think he was ready to go. And I was feeling a little awkward too, and it shows.
I love that photo because it's so real. Like, I know you don't think of it as one of your best moments, Jim, but it is so real. Like, you're both just like super awkward.
Sarah likes to see me in turmoil.
No, I just think it's funny. It makes me smile. And then I know the story behind it. That. Like, now that I know the story behind the photo, like, it's even better. Right? That you were forced into it.
I remember it. I remember that show was a pop-up. So you didn't have, but 5 days? Or less than that to go to that show because it was a late pop-up, wasn't it? That wasn't a planned one. That was early. That was like a late pop-up. You had like 5 days left.
He always seems to get added on at the end, but I can't remember with that beginning. I'd have to go back and look.
I thought it was a couple days. I know that a lot of people wanted to go and they couldn't go. So most of the people in the group know this story, but you did at some point last year, I can't remember the exact date, got a tattoo of a symbol. Thank God it came back, because I was a little worried about the emergence of the symbol, because it did disappear for quite a while. And I was like, oh, Lord, Tom has the symbol, and now he doesn't use it anymore. But then it came back, so it's fine. But tell us, like, about the symbol, because you did get a symbol tattooed on your arm, and it's pretty infamous in the clubs, and we all know about it. But tell us about, like, why you got the tattoo. You know, I know that he knows that you have the tattoo.
Yeah, I mean, I remember going to the Nashville show. He was so nice to my daughter. I mean, I remember the beginning that, you know, the music really affected me. And so how, with the music that I first was listening to back probably in February or March of 2019, and the love for that, it just kept on going. It kept on going. And I was lucky because I donated money to the Music Tree to help out the kids that were struggling, you know, and didn't have the things they need. So I donated a little bit. I was thankful to actually win my trip over there to Pomona. After the Nashville show, I felt the love in this man. When I shook his hand, he was such a freaking kind person, and just the way he is, so genuine and so just the person. When you meet somebody that you know that this is such a wonderful person, he's going to be a great person in life. He was so nice to my daughter. I thought to myself, what can I do to pay this man back or to honor him or to have something on my arm to look at to when I'm down or depressed? Because when I look at my tattoo and maybe I'm in a down mood, I don't get down anymore. I look at it and I think of the music, and the music puts a smile on my face. So I get to a better place in my life, and the tattoo helps me remind me of the music and the love and the caring person that this man is. Regardless if he keeps the emblem or not, I'm always going to remember his music from it. That's where I was, you know, always thankful to Alejandro for the happiness that he's given me. So, you know, that's one of the reasons why I got the tattoo. You know, it's something I'll always look at and something I'll always remember and something I'll always be happy for that I got it.
No, I love that story. I do. I think that he is a very genuine guy, and he truly appreciates people and kids. And I think he relates to kids a lot, as we saw from the Idol coming home parade thing. Hey guys, don't forget to like and subscribe on our YouTube channel, and definitely check out scaryfanparty.com for all the latest news.